The Java Collections Framework, a deeper dive. The Java Collections Framework provides a unified architecture for storing and manipulating collections of objects. It consists of various interfaces and classes that define different collection types and their functionalities. Key interfaces. Collection. This is the root interface for all collections in Java. It defines basic operations like adding and removing elements, checking size, and iterating over elements. List. Represents an ordered sequence of elements, allowing duplicate elements and offering access through indices. Implementations include ArrayList, dynamically sized, and LinkedList, doubly linked list. Set. Represents a collection of unique elements, unordered and without duplicates. Implementations include HashSet, based on HashTable, and TreeSet, sorted set. Map. Represents a key-value pair association, where each key maps to a single value. Implementations include HashMap, unordered, and TreeMap, sorted by keys. Key classes. ArrayList, dynamically sized list backed by an array, providing efficient random access but slower insertion, deletion in the middle. Linked list, doubly linked list offering efficient insertion, deletion at any position but slower random access. HashSet, unordered set using a hash table for fast lookup and insertion, deletion. TreeSet, sorted set based on a red-black tree, offering efficient element search and sorted iteration. HashMap, unordered key-value map based on a hash table, providing fast access based on keys. TreeMap, sorted key-value map based on a red-black tree, offering efficient element search and sorted iteration. Collection framework operations. The framework provides various methods for performing common operations on collections, including adding and removing elements, checking for element existence, finding the size of the collection, iterating through elements, sorting elements, searching for elements, converting between different collection types. Benefits of using the Java Collections Framework. Reduced development time. You can use existing data structures and algorithms instead of implementing them yourself. Improved code quality. The framework promotes consistent and modular code due to reusable components. Enhanced performance. The framework offers optimized implementations for different operations. Reduced errors. Strong type safety and robust functionality minimize code bugs. Increased flexibility. The framework allows for choosing the most suitable collection type for your specific needs. Understanding the ArrayList code line by line. 1. Import Java, util, ArrayList. This line imports the ArrayList class from the Java, util package. This class allows us to create and manipulate ordered lists of objects. 2. Public class ArrayList example. This line defines the beginning of a public class named ArrayList example. This class will contain our code for working with the ArrayList. 3. Public static void main, string, args. This line defines the main method of the ArrayList example class. This is the entry point for our program and where our code will be executed. 4. ArrayList less than integer greater than numbers equals new ArrayList less than greater than. This line creates a new instance of an ArrayList with the type parameter integer. This means that the list can only hold objects of type integer. 5. Numbers linked to .add, 1. This line adds the integer value 1 to the numbers list. 6. Numbers linked to .add, 3. This line adds the integer value 3 to the numbers list. 7. Numbers linked to .add, 2. This line adds the integer value 2 to the numbers list. 8. Int first number equals numbers linked to .get, 0. This line retrieves the element at index 0 of the numbers list and stores it in the variable first number. Index 0 represents the first element in the list. 9. Int second number equals numbers linked to .get, 1. This line retrieves the element at index 1 of the numbers list and stores it in the variable second number. Index 1 represents the second element in the list. 10. Int size equals numbers, size. This line gets the size of the numbers list and stores it in the variable size. 11. For int number, numbers. This line defines a loop that iterates through each element in the numbers list. The variable number will hold each element in turn. 12. System linked to dot out. Print ln number. This line prints the current element, number, to the console. 13. This line closes the loop. 14. This line closes the main method. 15. This line closes the ArrayList example class. This code demonstrates basic functionalities of an ArrayList, including creating an ArrayList instance, adding elements to the list, accessing elements by index, getting the size of the list, iterating through all elements. By understanding these functions, you can effectively use ArrayList for storing and manipulating ordered data in your Java programs. Understanding the linked list code line by line. 1. Import Java, util, linked list. This line imports the linked list class from the Java, util package. This class allows us to create and manipulate ordered lists of objects with faster insertion and deletion capabilities compared to ArrayList. 2. Public class linked list example. This line defines the beginning of a public class named linked list example. This class will contain our code for working with the linked list. 3. Public static void main, string, args. This line defines the main method of the linked list example class. This is the entry point for our program and where our code will be executed. 4. Linked list less than string greater than names equals new linked list less than greater than. This line creates a new instance of a linked list with the type parameter string. This means that the list can only hold objects of type string. 5. Names linked to .add, John. This line adds the string, John, to the names list. 6. Names linked to .add, Mary. This line adds the string, Mary, to the names list. 7. Names linked to .add, Peter. This line adds the string, Peter, to the names list. 8. String first equals names, get first. This line retrieves the first element, head, of the names list and stores it in the variable first. 9. String last equals names, get last. This line retrieves the last element, tail, of the names list and stores it in the variable last. 10. Names, remove first. This line removes the first element, head, from the names list. 11. Boolean exists equals names, contains, Mary. This line checks if the element, Mary, exists in the names list and stores the result, true, false, in the variable exists. 12. For, string name, names. This line defines a loop that iterates through each element in the names list. The variable name will hold each element in turn. 13. System link to dot out, print ln, name. This line prints the current element, name, to the console. 14. This line closes the loop. 15. This line closes the main method. 16. This line closes the linked list example class. This code demonstrates basic functionalities of a linked list, including creating a linked list instance, adding elements to the list, accessing the first and last elements, removing the first element, checking if an element exists, iterating through all elements. By understanding these functions, you can effectively use linked list for storing and manipulating ordered data in your Java programs, especially when faster insertion and deletion operations are crucial. Understanding the hashSet code line by line. 1. Import Java, util, hashSet. This line imports the hashSet class from the Java, util package. This class allows us to create and manipulate unordered sets of objects, ensuring no duplicate elements exist within the set. 2. Public class hashSet example. This line defines the beginning of a public class named hashSet example. This class will contain our code for working with the hashSet. 3. Public static void main, string, args. This line defines the main method of the hashSet example class. This is the entry point for our program and where our code will be executed. 4. Hashset less than string greater than colors equals new hashset less than greater than. This line creates a new instance of a hashset with the type parameter string. This means that the set can only hold objects of type string. 5. Colors link to dot add red. This line adds the string red to the colors set. 6. Colors link to dot add green. This line adds the string green to the colors set. 7. Colors link to dot add blue. This line adds the string blue to the colors set. 8. Colors link to dot add red. This line attempts to add the string red again, but it will be ignored since the set already contains it and doesn't allow duplicates. 9. Int size equals colors size. This line gets the size of the colors set and stores it in the variable size. Since duplicates are ignored, the size will be 3 even though red was added twice. 10. Boolean exists equals colors contains blue. This line checks if the element blue exists in the colors set and stores the result true, false in the variable exists. 11. For string color colors. This line defines a loop that iterates through each element in the colors set. The variable color will hold each element in turn. 12. System link to dot out. Print ln color. This line prints the current element color to the console. Due to the unordered nature of hash set, the order of elements printed might differ from actual insertion order. 13. This line closes the loop. 14. This line closes the main method. 15. This line closes the hashSet example class. This code demonstrates basic functionalities of a hashSet, including creating a hashSet instance, adding elements to the set, checking if an element exists, getting the size of the set, ignoring duplicates, iterating through all elements. Order might be different than insertion order. By understanding these functions, you can effectively use hashSet for storing and manipulating unordered collections with unique elements, optimizing for efficient searching and avoiding data redundancy. Understanding the tree set code line by line. 1. Import Java, util, tree set. This line imports the tree set class from the Java, util package. This class allows us to create and manipulate sorted sets of objects, ensuring no duplicate elements exist and maintaining an ascending order. 2. Public class tree set example. This line defines the beginning of a public class named TreeSetExample. This class will contain our code for working with the tree set. 3. Public static void main, string, args. This line defines the main method of the TreeSetExample class. This is the entry point for our program and where our code will be executed. 4. TreeSet less than integer greater than numbers equals new TreeSet less than greater than. This line creates a new instance of a tree set with the type parameter integer. This means that the set can only hold objects of type integer. 5. Numbers link to dot add 5. This line adds the integer value 5 to the numbers set. 6. Numbers link to dot add 2. This line adds the integer value 2 to the numbers set. Since tree set is ordered, the element will be placed before 5 due to its lower value. 7. Numbers link to dot add 8. This line adds the integer value 8 to the numbers set. Similar to before, the element will be placed after 5 due to its higher value. 8. For int number, numbers. This line defines a loop that iterates through each element in the numbers set. The variable number will hold each element in ascending order. 9. System link to dot out. Print ln number. This line prints the current element, number, to the console. Due to the sorted nature of tree set, elements will be printed in ascending order. 10. This line closes the loop. 11. Int first equals numbers, first. This line retrieves the first element, smallest element, of the numbers set and stores it in the variable first. 12. Int last equals numbers, last. This line retrieves the last element, largest element, of the numbers set and stores it in the variable last. 13. This line closes the main method. 14. This line closes the tree set example class. This code demonstrates basic functionalities of a tree set, including creating a tree set instance, adding elements to the set, iterating through all elements in ascending order, getting the first and last elements. By understanding these functions, you can effectively use tree set for storing and manipulating sorted sets of unique elements, enabling efficient searching and retrieval based on element values.